Hello everyone, my name is Juan and in today's video I'm going to show you how to import Excel data into Eviews. So to begin with, the first step is going to be to download our data, and for that I recommend you to use this website, which is the Federal Reserve Bank of St. Louis. And in the description of the video I'm going to provide you a couple more of websites where we can get access to different data sets. So in this case I'm going to be looking for soybean price. We get here the global price of soybeans. It's in US dollars per metric ton, and by default it's setting as monthly data. So right now it's going to show us our data set. This is the graph. We can go to edit the graph if we want, and we can change the frequency from monthly to quarterly. And the next step is going to be to click download. And in this case, we're going to select Excel. Downloaded our data set. We're going to open Eviews. The following screen is going to show. So we can either go to open an existing Eviews Word file, or if this screen doesn't show up, you can go into File. You're going to go into Import, Import from File. And in the following, I'm just going to go into my desktop, and here I have it. Make sure that you select all files, or make sure that it says Excel, because otherwise it's not going to show up document here. We're going to open, and we have two ways to import the data. We can just select Finish, and we're going to let Eviews predetermine all the settings, or we can customize our data set. I'm going to customize it. For example, I wouldn't like to have this first row, so I'm going to click here. And as you can see now, that first row has disappeared. I'm going to select Next. In this window, I'm not going to change anything. And in the following screen, step three, what we can do is, first of all, we can change the title. For example, I don't want observation date. I just want to say time. And here, what we are telling Eviews is the type of data that we are working with. In this case, this is time. The following, for example, I would like to say price of soybean, and it's a number, so that's fine. We're going to select Next. And in this case, what we can do is change the structure of our data set in terms of the date. For example, in this case, we're going to let it specify by the date series, which was quarterly data. That's what we downloaded. But if we wanted to change these, for example, to annual, semi-annual, monthly, weekly, we could definitely do this. And what Eviews is going to do is going to create more observations or less observations, and it's going to average our data to make it monthly or to make it weekly. However, I always recommend for you to leave the data specified by our data series. And the last step is just clicking Finish. And here we have already our information loaded into the Eviews. So I hope you like this video, you find it useful, and I recommend you to stick to the channel, subscribe, because new videos are going to be submitted, where I'm going to be teaching you some other commands and how to do different things in the Eviews. So thank you very much for watching.